And thank you. Well, right now we're joined by BGE spokesperson Rob Gould. And Rob, I know your crews have already been out busy in the neighborhoods getting ready. I'm sure you've had a busy couple of days, but.
Yeah, we're taking this very seriously. Mm-hmm. Realize this thing's going to move around, but we're planning for the worst right now. And we expect that we're going to get hammered. The extent of the hammer, who knows at this point. Right.
If you're expecting that, are you also expecting widespread outages?
Yeah, I think that's the point that we're really concerned about, that we're going to see outages. Depending on the flow, you know, we've been saying throughout the day and realizing that it could shift, this could be as bad, if not worse, mm-hmm. as compared to Irene or Isabel.
Right.
Those were significant outages. We had upwards of almost 800,000 customers without power. So we're making some significant preparations in advance.
Yeah, and you know, I think the derecho earlier this year really got people so scared and upset because the power outages were so long. How many crews and personnel do you have on standby or people who could be called in?
So typically we go after about 1,000, but this time we've actually doubled that. We're after 2,000 utility workers from out of state. We hope to have them coming in. We've got line of sight on about 800 of those already from as far away as Oklahoma, New Mexico, and Texas.
Wow.
They're already en route coming to us. And we will keep going after them. But the problem is that the utilities to the south, the utilities to the west, and certainly to the north and Canada don't want to release their crews yet because they don't know where this thing's
right.
going.
Right.
Yeah, speaking of that derecho, there were some problems because of all the damage, trying to get out to assess the damage, and as a result, try to begin the restoration process. What are you doing in anticipation of that possibly happening again?
Well, we're going to have the same situation, I can tell you that, because what's going to happen is we've got crews that are going to be not able to get out there while we have this long duration event.
Mm-hmm.
So we likely will not even be out there assessing until the storm really subsides,
right.
which means restoration not even starting till Tuesday or Wednesday.
Yeah, because you can't send your crews out right in the thick of a storm because of the injury factor to them.
That, and not only that, the buckets that they fly
sure.
in, they don't work after 25 miles an hour.
Gotcha.
So it's very unsafe to put them out there.
Gotcha.
Yeah, and we're also just getting word that Maryland utility companies can no longer charge customers for lost sales
right.
during the first 24 hours of a power outage. Can you explain
yeah,
a little bit more
about
that?
Yeah, this was an issue that was of concern to the customers,
right.
and it's got a long history behind it. But at the end of the day, we're fine with that. The commission made its ruling, and we understand that. And we've said all along, commission tells us not to charge, we won't do it.
Right. You know, I have this feeling, I know this is probably a vain hope, that the derecho shook out a lot of bad trees and bad limbs that would fall, and so maybe it's going to be better this time?
So there are leaves still on the trees. So imagine an umbrella, imagine a parachute.
Oh, yeah.
The leaves, you know, act like that,
right.
and they still go into it. Now, the good news is you have a lot of those leaves that are off the trees.
Mm-hmm.
So you're kind of in that middle ground. Hopefully some of those leaves are weakened, but you still have a heavy canopy tree line. So
right.
still a challenge for us. And again, the biggest thing customers can do, keep that number handy, because until we have smart meters throughout the territory, we don't know that there's a loss of power.
Right.
So you're going to hear us say that over and over again, but call us, let us know you're out of service.
All right. Rob, I'm quite sure we'll be seeing quite a bit of you over the next couple of days. I'll be here tomorrow night working, so best of luck
too.
To everybody, and thanks for coming in.
Yeah.
And again, we'll
and tell
see you
the
crews
thank you, too, in advance.
We will, and patience from our customers, we would really
sure.
appreciate it.
All right,
we'll
do.
Thanks.
All right. Now, just talked to Rob about some of the issues that they'll be facing over the next couple of days. We've got a couple ideas for you. For example, Rob just mentioned you need to call, for example, BGE now. You can report tree limbs that could fall on your power lines. If they were sort of tenuous in the last storm, looks like they're leaning right now, give them a call. Maybe they'll be able to get out and get to that tree before the storm hits. Also, turn on your fridge to the maximum coldest setting and keep the door closed. That way your food will stay fresh a little longer. You might want to clean any storm drains around your house in the neighborhood so the water doesn't accumulate and eventually get inside your home. And should you lose power, as Rob just said, BGE wants you to call them and let them know. Don't assume others in your neighborhood have done that. The number to call for an outage, 1-877-778-2222.
Yeah, I just cleaned out a storm drain at my house this morning. It was packed with leaves. You can also track Hurricane Sandy's movements on our interactive radar, see the satellite images, and follow storm updates on LiveWire. You'll find it all on WBALTV.com and on our mobile app.